The scenery is breathtaking. Rushing rivers. Picturesque prairies. Many parts of western Montana look untouched by man. It's small town America. Everyone knows your name. People come from around the world to fish the Blackfoot River and other waters. Norman MacLean made the Blackfoot famous in the 1976 novel, A River Runs Through It. Today, there's a threat to this popular pastime.
Some are concerned about trouble from climate change and other human influences. In this wild country, it may be that science needs to save the day.
Global warming is putting the state fish, the West Slope cutthroat trout, in danger.
All right, we're gonna need the net, the electrofisher, and all the pit tagging equipment.
Clint Mulfeld monitors fish and rivers for the U.S. Geological Survey. They're looking for solutions.
This area is actually warming at 2 to 3 times the global average. The worst case scenario would be that the rivers dry up, warm up too much, to the point where trout can't inhabit these waters anymore. Nothing like sampling trout in Montana.
Mulfeld and his team work the streams in Glacier National Park.
All right, let's start here.
This is kind of iconic. It's the poster child of climate warming in North America. As temperatures start increasing, we can actually see fish starting to move up the mountainsides.
That means the trout migrating from the streams in Glacier National Park for cooler waters.
This should be a good day.
We go into small streams and we use a backpack electrofisher and we electrocute the water. It draws the fish in. We then net each fish.
I'm gonna start shocking here. Oh, there's one right there. Cutthroat. Chaka Khan, we're on.
What are we doing?
Surveying a stream where we hope to tag some native West Slope cutthroat trout.
What's the concern here?
Warming temperatures are actually causing the snow melt to come off sooner. Fish are really keyed into temperature and flow.
These fish like it cold.
They like it cold. Sooner or later, there's gonna be nowhere else to go. Yup, there's one, little cutthroat.
How important are the fish in these streams to Montana?
Well, these streams are actually the lifeblood of Montana. They provide nursery areas for our native fish.
After capturing numerous fish, the team sets up a triage on the side of the stream.
We take critical measurements, such as length and weight. Its length is 92 millimeters, and its weight is just a mere 5 grams.
How do you know it's a cutthroat trout?
If it has a vibrant red or orange slash under the gill. Also, we take a genetic clip to determine its genetic status. And then we also put a tag in their body cavity. And that allows us to track individual movements.
They've strategically placed antennas under parts of the stream so they can track the fish when they swim by. Mulfeld says there are some short-term solutions.
Stocking fish in these rivers, restoring habitat, providing complexity of streams, rivers, and lakes for them to move around in, and also developing conservation plans that actually look out over longer time periods.
Warmer temperatures are affecting everything across the region, the economy and the people. 71-year-old Paul Roos has been fishing the Blackfoot River for 65 years.
I have a passion for this river that I think was earned honestly.
Can you tell me a fond memory of being out here with your father?
I was with my father when I caught my first fish. I was with him when he caught his last.
When the rivers reach 73 degrees for 3 consecutive days, the state closes the rivers to fishing because it puts too much stress on the fish.
when there's no people coming to fish in July and August and September, you notice it. It's important to contribute to something that is going to last after I'm gone. Pretend like you have a paintbrush in your hand, and then as soon as the line straightens, it's going to drop, and you just drop the rod with it.
Bring it back.
Beautiful.
Rancher Gemstone is also affected by changing temperatures. He is a second-generation Montana rancher. He's adapting his ranch to not only help his business, but the fishing industry too.
What does being a rancher mean to you?
It's an honor, really, to be a manager of a piece of land. It's the survival of our family.
What happens if it doesn't rain here?
If we don't have grass, we're not able to feed those cows you see behind us. If we're not selling calves at $1.64 a pound, then that's taking money directly out of our wallet.
He's finding new ways to manage water with the help of groups like Trout Unlimited.
We've set up partnerships to both help the river by helping these tributaries and at the same time helping these people trying to make a living off of this land.
On Stone's ranch, they've been able to get his water table back to the surface and help the fisheries.
It's a complete win-win for us and really reconnected the fisheries. One of the star programs that we have here is all the irrigators, the outfitters, working together and trying to leave as much water in the river for the fish. We can give water back and still be productive.
Do you think the cutthroat trout can be saved?
I do.
Only on Al Jazeera America.
A team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature.
Technology is a vital part of who we are.
They had some dynamic fire behavior.
And what we do.
Transcranial direct stimulation. Don't try this at home.
Techno's team of experts show you how the miracles of science.
This is my selfie. What can you tell me about my future?
Can affect and surprise us.
Sharks like affection.
Catch new episodes of Techno on Al Jazeera America. Check your local listings or visit aljazeera.com.